I didn't want to interrupt.
Nicer than this one, though.
An old magazine featuring the country's 10 smallest towns. Number one is someplace called Shady Brook. Ugh, it smelled heavily of mildew. Plenty of lockers. Not enough time to look through them all. There's some kind of smoke. Can't breathe in here.
I kind of feel like I'm at home in this room, at least.
Ugh, Warden Duval was a sick man. These security monitors, are they live?
Indeed they are. Our captor has been watching us.
There goes Sonny. He must be in the cell blocks.
As I said, we are being watched.
Wonder what this does.
Sonny managed to find one. If you want to use the machine, then perhaps you can find one too. I believe that is what Sonny has been using to control the gates, but it requires a key. Sonny managed to find one. If you want to use the machine, then perhaps...
There was no power. I needed to insert the proper key into the keyhole first. Filing cabinets, empty, down to the last drawer. Ugh, corporate propaganda like... That particular monitor was non-operational. Oh God. I think this was written by the killer.
Indeed it was. He, or she, is among us, Will. Be careful.
Everywhere I look, I'm surrounded by death. Filing cabinets, empty, down. Various prison documents, nothing worthwhile. The batteries inside the radio were heavily corroded. Whoever worked in here had a nicer chair than the guards at the other stations. I wonder where it leads. Inside the left coat pocket were a scrap of paper and a small key. I took both. The key didn't. I wonder what this does.
I believe.
Breathe at least, but I still need to find a way to block the flow of gas. I needed to get rid of the smoke before I could look around. That trash bag would have been perfect to seal the vent, if it weren't full of holes. The faucet knob turned, but no water emerged. The rusted sink was dry, as though it hadn't been turned on in years. I needed to seal this vent before I could look around. Ugh, it smelled heavily. A full checkers set, complete with a wooden carrying box to boot. Too bad I hate. The garbage bag was too large and bulky to use as is. They're not loaded.
Hey, you got it open. Good. What you got there?
Nothing.
Don't say nothing. Let me see.
Not seeing any way out of this situation, I handed one of the guns to Gerard. They aren't loaded.
Yeah, well, we'll worry about that later. For now, lead the way.
What do you mean, lead the...
You seem pretty clever. I'm not letting you out of my sight. Until you clear the smoke.
The garbage bag was too large.
Have you been inside the warden's office yet? I found the key. Here, let me open it for you.
John Edward Duval, Warden. Seems like a bit of an egotist.
What a dick.
Several shot glasses sat upon a small end table. The warden must have liked to drink.
I could use it.
You have no idea. No reel was loaded into the projector. I picked up the phone. No dial tone, of course.
I guess I got my hopes up for nothing.
It was cold enough in here without turning on a fan. These Bible quotes are all related to sins and justice. A chart translating letters and odd symbols. It seems like the warden liked to write in code. I wonder why. This memo mentions something about the floor in the guard's restroom.
Might be worth checking out.
Some kind of scripture. Definitely not Christian. It continually references the old ones, whatever that means. All the pages were blank. The entire history of Stonewall Penitentiary, condensed into a few articles. The drawers may have been empty. But there was more than enough to read on the desk itself. Expensive encyclopedias, dishware, and other related paraphernalia. This warden had extravagant tastes. An honorary psychology doctorate with a concentration in the criminal mind from the National College of Law and Psychology. The 1954 Excellence in Standard Operations Award. Congratulations, Warden.
I won Employee of the Month once where I worked. Didn't get any plaque, though.
Antique globe of the world. This must be worth a fortune. A small hole was embedded in the top, as though the globe was missing something.
I had one of these as a kid. Not as nice, though.
An antique globe. Far more decorative than the lights elsewhere in the prison. It seems Warden Duval spared no expense in building this office. An old reel projector was pointed toward the bookshelves at the back of the room. Just your standard roll-down projector screen. live visual feed, courtesy of the security cameras that are scattered throughout this place.
Creepy.
The refrigerator is slightly ajar.
Until you clear the smoke.
I tucked the bag into the vent. It held in place, but smoke still escaped. I carefully sealed the vent with the electrical tape, and the smoke quickly dissipated. Satisfied, I removed the gas mask. Luckily, I didn't have to go. Do you ever jump when you see your own reflection out of the corner of your eye? Yeah, that just happened. Luckily, I didn't have to go. Luckily, this vent was clear of smoke. The floor is definitely patched here.
Not well, either. It would be easy to break up.
That's a long way down.
Might be, but it might be sure enough to jump. We need to find a ball or something to drop down the hole. Listen to how long it takes to hit the ground. I'll wait here. We'll see if we can find a ball or something.
was so parched I didn't... I haven't held a basketball since.
Will! Hey! Up here!
Sonny? How did you get up there?
There's no time to explain! I need you to... Hello? Who's there?
Sonny! Oh no, he's not moving! Attention everyone, we need to talk, right now. Meet me in reception.
With heavy heart, I met the others once again in reception.
Why do we have to keep meeting here?
Will, what happened?
It's Sonny. He found a way onto the roof, but someone pushed him off. I saw him fall. He knocked his head on some pipes. He's dead.
I find it intriguing that Sonny's fate was to die in the same way as his friend did in the story Sonny told us.
He's not the only one. Becca also died similarly to a death from her past. She was electrocuted, just like she killed her husband in a bath, she told me earlier.
And Lewis as well. He confessed to me that he was responsible for a stuntman getting crushed on set.
I heard that as well.
You're saying this nut's trying to teach us a lesson?
He called it justice.
Well, justice or not, this is as far as it goes. I've seen all those B-rate slasher films. The second we separate, bam, another one of us dies. I say we stay together.
Safety in numbers?
If the killer is among us, then it does seem the logical thing to do.
So what's our next move?
Gerard and I made a large hole in the bathroom floor.
It looks like it goes down pretty far, but we may be able to jump it.
It might be our ticket out of this place.
Gentlemen, lead the way.